Yeah.
Can I ask you a question? Does this top make me look massive?
I found out since we've been dating, in my heart you're really waiting. No wonder your heart beats the sweet.
Hello everyone, Cliona here, and I'm here to tell you about my brand new album, which is called Secret Love. I'm back in the studio where some of the songs were recorded, and I just love the whole vibe of the studio, and we've been here for quite a few months, and it is just amazing that all the work that we've put into it has actually come to an end. The whole world says now that's alright. First and foremost, I feel like I've been very, very lucky. I've been able to work with amazing producers, musicians, and songwriters, and I am so, so happy to be here today with you all to talk about my new album, Secret Love. So the first track of the album is an old Jim Reeves song. I absolutely love the old country feel, and when I heard it, I just immediately clicked with the song. I love the old time lyrics as well, and I think now, because of the evolution of country music, the old time lyrics are really quite modern and cool and hip now. And when I heard the old song, I immediately thought that maybe I'll speed it up a wee bit. But when we did that, I actually didn't realise the song was so short. So I took it upon myself to do a little bit of songwriting for the first time in my life. And I would love to see if you can spot which verse is actually mine. Also within this track as well, during the studio, I like to be silly from time to time, and as you do, I was just yodeling and messing about. And when the producers heard it, they were like, no, Cliona, the yodel is actually going to fit really well with this track. And I suppose, again, it correlates with the cowboy yodel. You've got a little bit of that as well, which I'm kind of known for at the minute. So it really came together, a brand new verse and a little bit of a yodel, and speed it up. And I'm very delighted with it. So here's my very, very first track, The Wilder Your Heart Beats. The wilder your heart beats, the sweeter your love. It brightens the moonlight for us to make our love. Each time I kiss and hold you tight, the whole world says now that's alright. The wilder your heart beats, the sweeter you love. The wilder your heart beats, the sweeter you love. Song which I'm going to play for you, it's track 4 of the album, and it's called Old Flames. I know everyone would know this song. It has been a favourite of mine for so long. I actually sang it in my set for years within the band, and I dropped it out a while back, and the reason being, I just like to keep changing up my songs, but the amount of requests that I got for it, I had to put it back into my set. It's a beautiful song. And I really wanted always to record it. And when I went to the producer, I wanted to change it up a wee bit. And I suppose just some of the phrasing, for example.
Sometimes at night I think of old lovers I've known.
And I just wanted to change the phrasing because it's such a well-known song. To suit my style, and when I went into the producer, he just told me to sing it from the heart, and I got really lost within the song, and I was so happy with how it came out. So very, very happy that I've got my stamp on such a classic song. So without further ado, here is Old Flames.
Old Flames can't hold a candle to you. Love, I'm on one or two.
going to talk to you all about is actually the single, the very first single, which was released from the second album, which is called Born to Run. I was delighted with the positive reviews that we received from Born to Run. Everyone was beyond supportive. And when I'm out at night performing and singing, it's definitely a track that everyone would ask for, and the dancers as well seem to really love it. And yeah, I was so proud of how it turned out. It was actually made in this beautiful studio by the brilliant Dave Arkins down at Crookedwood Studios in Slane. It was definitely a great track, and I loved the video as well. It was so much fun making it. We decided to do a video which was basically rally cars were racing each other, and of course I had to take part in this as well. I didn't do all the stunts, mind you, but it was good fun getting to drive a rally car for the day. So without further ado, let's listen to a little bit of Born to Run.
Well, I never did crawl and I never did toe the line. Nobody is a master to me, I ain't that kind. I just put on my traveling shoes. If you wanna win, you just can't lose the time or stay behind. Well, I was born to run, to get ahead of the rest. And all that I wanted was to be the best, just to feel free and be someone. I was born to be fast, I was born.
Just like any other classic country song, you know, you always hear a story, whether it be about cheating or drinking, you know, honky tonk or whatnot. This next song, which I'm gonna play for you all, is definitely no exception. It's called Stop Cheating on Me. It is track 10 off the album, and it was produced by the brilliant Jonathan Owens in Spout Studio down in Longford.
Stop cheating on me.
I like it.
Stop cheating on me, or I'll start cheating on you.
Last line.
Oh, or I'll start cheating on you. Oh, stop cheating. Okay, Cliona.
So as you can clearly see, we have way too much fun in the studios at times, playing with the pianos and whatnot. It was definitely great fun making that single, Stop Cheating on Me, which we released on May past. It was great, it got great airplay on the radios and people were requesting it, so that is always a huge plus in my book. And it's actually a great foxtrot to do out at night as well for the dancers. So if you're out at our shows, you know, Stop Cheating on Me will be in the set. So here it is, Stop Cheating on Me, or I'll Stop Cheating on You.
Baby, we used to have something special, but lately you've been ignoring all the rules. Well, you think that I don't know what you're doing. You've been running around and making cheating on me. It ain't that hard to do. Stop cheating on me, or I'll start cheating on you.
So here's Head Over Boots. When I first heard this song, it just is such a chilled out, relaxing song. I can imagine myself opening a beer or taking a glass of wine, relaxing, listening to this song. It's definitely got that summer feel to it, so I really do hope you like it.
You're the one I want, you're the one I need, baby. If I was a queen, you'd be my king. You're the rock in my road, you're good for my soul, it's true. I'm head over boots for you. I know you could have a few.
More with that came from. I have loved this song for many years. It's an upbeat, fun song, and it's definitely one for the jivers. This song, it's got a beautiful melody, it's got beautiful words, and it tells a gorgeous story, so it does. So here is the band played an old time waltz.
And the band played an old time waltz, just an old time waltz. The first time he met her, they danced together to an old time waltz.
This time, just for dancing, not for fighting. Here is one called McCarthy's Party. It was a single released from the album. I first heard it off an old Eileen Donaghy record, and I wanted to reword it and change it up a bit. It's definitely an upbeat song with a very, very catchy chorus. We done a video for it down in Westport at a bar actually called McCarthy's Bar. It was great fun, and thankfully nobody fell out or started to fight. So here is McCarthy's Party.
McCarthy's Party, everyone was hearty till someone hit Maloney on the nose with a handle of a broom. McCarthy cleared the room, then another hour rose. It was crazy. Murphy and his cousin, lies half a dozen, they showed nobody mercy. They caused a lot of bother and fell out with one another down at McCarthy's Party. Oh yes, they caused a lot of bother and fell out with one another down at McCarthy's Party.
So the next song which we're going to listen to is the last track off the album. It's an original written by the brilliant Henry McMahon, and it's called Country Found Me. It's based basically on how I actually found country. It's chatting about my life and talking about Britney Spears and the Spice Girls, and only Henry McMahon could work his magic to get both of those acts in. It chats about how I went to college, and here is how country found me.
I grew up in the '90s, like the girls of my age, when the Spice Girls and Britney were all the rage. Then I went off to college, got a music degree, still never.
We've come to the very, very last title track, which is the title of the album, Secret Love. I love this song. It is from my favourite film of all time, Calamity Jane. And when I first heard Doris Day singing it all those years ago, when I was sitting watching the film with my granddad, I was just like, I love the song, and it was just so meaningful to me. So I had to get one of my loves into the album as well. So I'm going to play for you all Secret Love. It's a 1950s song, and we added a little bit of rockabilly to it. So I hope you all enjoy my album Secret Love, and thanks for even taking the time to listen to me. Here's Secret Love.
And open door, and my secret love's no secret.